Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Rebuilding Portsmouth. Now, I was looking through my demographic thingy in my, analytics page on my YouTube account, and I've got to tell you, I'm pretty much spot on when I say, hey guys, because up until about a week ago, I'm pretty certain it was 100%, the pie chart was 100% male. But I looked at it yesterday, because it doesn't always load very well, but I looked at it yesterday and I noticed there was a tiny little sliver of female users. So whoever you are, firstly, that's strange because there aren't that many female FM players, I don't think. I'm not really sure about that. Like, that pie chart, if that pie chart was a pie chart of things you would do if you won the lottery, the female bit is the give it to charity slice, okay? So, well done. I think I even had a female subscriber, so that's cool too. It's not creepy, it's just surprising. So, awesome. Other thing is, today when you're watching this, is Thursday, most likely, which means that yesterday I had an operation, which is why hopefully there won't be any gaps in videos, like days where there aren't any, because I have been trying to build them up so that I can get through it without and take a couple of days off without actually having to work, because I won't be able to speak properly. So hopefully that you won't notice any gaps in tomorrow's videos, which will be done much, much later, will still seamlessly fit onto the end, which is, of course, why I couldn't livecom the last game, because I had to do a batch recording. Now, that's enough admin. Let's get straight into the month. And, it's been a strange one. First, I'm just going to check transfers, because I'm not sure if we made any more new signings since... No. Okay, we didn't make any more new signings since the last episode. I was pretty happy with what we got. We did, however... No, we didn't, actually. What am I talking about? Let's go straight back to the schedule, and let's just get straight into the games. Because, although I normally show... Well, I don't normally show you a highlight of a game when we're doing a live com, there is something that happened in one of these games that I really want to show you, because it is the stupidest thing I've ever seen so far on Football Manager this year. Now, I should also point out that this is now running the updated version of the beta, so it's 15.0.3. is the one I'm using now. But when I played these games that you're seeing, which was earlier today, before I went off and had something to eat, it was still the old version. So this was all on the old update. But the Coventry game is going to be the first time I'm actually ever going to try out the new match engine, the updates that they've made to it since the last buggy release. Yeah, anyway, so there's some bullshit I want to show you, but we'll get onto that in a minute. Firstly, we're going to take a little look at the Peterborough United game. And when I say take a little look, I mean howl at the moon and wonder what the hell went wrong. We got a baptism of fire in this league, basically. I'm just going to go back to the other page again, where you can actually see what happened. Is there a way of making this bigger? Like, so you can actually see what's written here? Because what's the point in this screen if it doesn't show you the date, the stats properly? That's something that obviously hasn't been fixed. Anyway, we'll look at it on this screen instead. So Andrew Halliday was able to score two goals for Peterborough. He put them in front, but then we actually managed to... Well, and then Paul Jones scored an own goal. Our goalkeeper. Wonderful. How brilliant of him. Was able to score an own goal for Peterborough, which helped put them level. It was a bit of a bullshit goal in its own right, as with a lot of these own goals. But then Miles Storey got us back in the game, once again proving that he's just such a good player. Unfortunately, just after half-time, Andrew Halliday made it 3-1, and then another own goal from our goalkeeper. Yeah, that's right, we scored two own goals in the same game. Goalkeepers are broken. Hopefully they fixed that, though, so... Because this month has been... I know I called another episode of another... Probably, I think it was another series, actually. No, it was a Portsmouth episode called Goalkeepers Are Broken. I probably should have saved that title for this month. But yeah, so we didn't start off the best and actually found ourselves bottom of the table, I think. Or no, I think Mansfield actually won 5-1 on the opening day, so I don't think we were bottom, but we were right down there. We had a little bit of a respite from that as we played in the Capital One Cup midweek, and we were able to beat Sheffield United. That's right, we beat them. They took the lead early on, not that early on, sorry, they took the lead in the 36th minute through Jim O'Brien, who sounds like a snooker player, but is in fact a football player and scored a good header from a corner. But immediately, John Marcus, who obviously I'd put in here because Miles Storey was a little bit knackered, although we did actually play Storey as a sort of advanced midfielder in this game. Marcus scored a 13-minute hat-trick in this game to flip the game on its head. This lad can finish. I shit you not, he's had a brilliant month. And you'll see as that carries on. He's not even started that many games. He's so good when he starts. He's just clinical with the finishing. And then Harrison McGahee was able to get one back for Sheffield United. But we managed to hang on, and we are through to the next... Well, we were through to the next round, which, once again, for the second year in a row, we've actually exceeded our objectives in the Capital One Cup, which certainly would have pleased our board. Next up, we had an absolutely ridiculous game against Port Vale, which, I gotta say, was fun to watch. And... Yeah, actually, I'll tell you what, if you were at that game, that would have been value for money, that's for sure. Jed Wallace put us in front early on, but then Stephen Hunt very quickly equalised for Port Vale before Chuba Akpom put them in front. Miles Storey then well, 4 minutes later was able to level the game up at 2-2 before Sean Batt, pretty much straight from the kickoff, put Port Vale 3-2 up at half-time. In the second half, however, I decided to throw it on overload and just see what happened. Well, what happened was... Yeah, Port Vale crumbled like a poorly built sandcastle. It was terrible, for them anyway. Miles Storey levelled just before the hour mark, and then Gary Gardner with a good header gave us the lead before John Marcus off the bench, sorry, not off the bench, he started this game, what we're talking about, started this game, was able to get yet another goal for himself, but he and Storey are looking like an absolute, they're not even playing as strike partners, but they're still able to get goals and were truly fabulous in this one. You'll see that Wes Fogden actually started this game too. We had to make quite a few changes. Ben Close has been getting a few more games too, because I believe, Danny Holland has a torn hamstring and will be out for 3 months, so has pretty much missed all of the season so far. It's not as bad as the player I've got out for 7 months in my St. Pauli series, to be fair. He's a youngster, but Jesus, 7 months? Anyway, next up, we had Mansfield at home. So the fact is, at this point, we've got ourselves 3 points in the league. We then had a home game, and I really hoped that we could win this, but it is Mansfield. And remember last year, they were the only side that kept a clean sheet against us. And they did it twice. This year, we saw better things. We went behind against them, as always, when Ryan Tafazzoli was able to put them in front. But then John Marcus, well, who else? The Marcus of Portsmouth was able to give us yet another goal and at least earn us a point in the game. So that gave us 4 points. Then came Bullshit Hour in the game against Yeovil. Now, we took the lead very early on through Jack Watmore. Then they equalised through probably the biggest piece of bullshit I've seen so far. And in order to prove that, oh, come on. Is there even a way I can do this? I suppose I could just show you that. But I only want to show you the highlight of that goal. Not all the goals, just that goal. Is there a way I can do that? Screw it. I'm just going to show you the highlights of this because... I want to show you the bullshit of that goal, so I'll see you guys in the highlights. Right, you join us just as Watmore, with a fantastic header actually, puts us into the lead. Now, what you're about to see is some bullshit. Watch what happens when they hit the crossbar here. Ball goes in. What? Did anyone else see that, or do we need to rewind that slightly? I'm going to make sure you guys see this, because look. O'Keefe takes the shot, ball hits the crossbar. Oh, actually, it's probably better in fast motion. Show me where this ball hits the goalkeeper. I didn't see it hit the goalkeeper. It just looked like it hit midair. I'm going to slow it right down. Hopefully this will help. Right. See if you can see where this hits the goalkeeper. Why is he laying on the floor? Right, okay, let's try that again. This is the one I wanted to show you. Like this. Because watch as Stuart O'Keefe steps up and takes this. Like, it's not even like the goalkeeper puts in his own net. So it bounces back off the crossbar, hits nothing, and bounces it. Nothing like an invisible wall to stop you from taking the result in that game. Marcus, of course, was able to pop up and grab us what we thought was the winner, but then James Barrett was able to score for them. Now, I'm not saying we deserved to win, although I think we did, because that goal was total bullshit. But this is one of those things that happens. And bear in mind, at this point, Yeovil had won all of their games, and we actually managed to do pretty well against them. So, 5 points, not too bad. Then we came back against Hull, and this was a strange one, because I actually... rotated my side. I put a rotated team out against a Premier League side and they took us to extra time. We very nearly won. Abel Hernandez scored a goal in the 87th minute to equalise for Hull. Yeah, they did have 36 shots. But the fact is, 87 minutes it took them to score a goal against us. We were very nearly through there, and that would have been the ultimate robbery, but oh well. So, without further ado, let's get into the Coventry game before this video goes on for way too long. Let's just take a quick look at the squad. As you can see, Marcus has got 6 goals in 3 starts, or 6 and 6 if you count his substitute appearances, which you kind of have to. Story also has 3 goals. Top assists, well, that's Jed Wallace, of course, with 3. Most player of the matches, that's Marcus with 2. Pass rating, well, that's Marcus as well, with 88%. That man can link play. Yellow cards, Story, and no reds, of course. Average rating, of course, is John Marcus as well. So let's get straight into the match today, because otherwise this video is going to go on for way too long. Right, so, plus I'm very curious to see what the new match engine looks like. So they're playing a 4-5-1, essentially. So I'm not sure what they're like for pace. Holmes is now out injured as well, which is a pain in the ass, but thankfully we do have Andy Barcham. They're not great for pace. Let's just turn that off for now. And I don't know what they're like for height. I might just keep it like that, and we'll kind of just play it by ear as we go along. Yeah, Bartram can come in. Fogden, Story, Wallace. Is Marcus a Marcus will probably be the ultimate impact sub in this game, to be honest, so I might just keep him where he is, to be honest. So let's just go with that and see what we can do. Coventry City, I don't know where they are in the league. I've lost kind of track. They're actually up in 10th, and as you can see, we're in 15th place. But we are 3 points clear of the relegation zone, and that's kind of okay. I think that's kind of where we were expected to be. But hopefully we can pull off a little bit more than that today. I'm not going to bother with that because I've got my instructions already set up. I don't know where... Isn't there normally a pitch thing in the background there? Oh, I see. That's right. We have to change this all back again, don't we? That's annoying. It's because I normally play on 2D Classic. Let's just switch that up. Things otherwise... This will be a pretty awkward game because I won't be able to do any tactical analysis if it's not on 2D Classic, because what I found in 3D match mode, I can't see anything. It makes it really, really difficult. Is that already changed? Oh, there was me waiting for something massive to happen before it did. Right, let's just move along here. Start match. Okay then. Oh, what? Apologies for this. No, that's not what I meant to click. Where's me thing? No. Right, that's my thing. I don't know where that went. Right, come on then. I'm so sorry about that. That's why I don't do it as well. Don't do highlights in episodes where I have live calls as well, because I have to mess with all the settings. Right, let's see what we can do here. It's a lovely pitch, I've got to say. Pat and Parker's looking delightful. Coventry have already had themselves a shot. That's not good. In fact, they've had 2 shots now, but we are dominating possession so far. Hopefully, we can turn that into something. But so far, there we go. We've had a couple of shots now. Fogden's had a knock, some headers. Looks like it's a pretty dull game so far. What can we do to change this? The thing is, we're not losing yet. So there's nothing to say that our system is inherently bad. I might just see how we go, actually. Right, here we go. Shorey with the ball in. Barcham, Fogden. Get it back out to Shorey. Oh, okay. Plays it back into Watmore. Surely he'll switch it to the right flank. Hayden Mullins now. Back to Adam Webster. Into Alex Winter here. Now, if he can make a little run, maybe just drop it in, or maybe just whip one in. Whips it long, and that is an absolutely shocking... Really? Why did the keeper touch that? Anyway, Nicky Shorey with the ball in. Watmore with the flick on. And, oh, that looks like it's about to be cleared. No. Shorey with the ball in. Watmore. And it's cleared in the end. I'm not really sure if that was the highlight, because I didn't really see anything particularly happen there, apart from a 2 who get injured for Coventry City. And that's a poor throw. Straight down to Alex Winter. Winter then whips it over the top for Jed Wallace. He can have a shot here. Back to Fogden. Barcham! Oh, that's got to be offside. If not, that's an amazing goal. How did I know that was going to be offside? He was just... it's a shame, because we're actually playing some alright football at the moment. So, that's the only thing that we can really say is good about this first half. We've not been special. But I don't want to change it too much, because Coventry aren't having that many chances themselves. Danny Pugh's been booked. Danny Pugh, didn't he just score a hat-trick in real life for Bournemouth in that 8-0 winner for Birmingham, or is that a different guy? No, it is, isn't it? I swear. Anyway, yeah, we know it's for the fans, but this feels like it's been changed slightly. Like they've made it more noticeable. This looks slightly more clean. Maybe that's what it was. Right, let's move on. Let's see what we can do in the second half. I might have to make some changes. They've not gone behind us at all, so I'm saying we can push higher up. And maybe I'll just push higher up for now. if we struggle to get the ball still, I mean, we're actually getting quite a lot of the ball, so they're obviously letting us have it, which is why it's not much of a problem so far. Wallace with the long ball. Oh, actually, Wallace has got it here. If he can whip it in well here, oh, nobody's on the end of it. But there's James Dunn in the midfield. If he can get it out right or left, either will do. Nicky Shorey now out on the left-hand side. Can he get a cross in or something? No, he's going to lose the ball there. But hey, we've started the second half quite strong as well. We just need to find some way through them. I may have to do a little in-match team talk here to try and just tweak things slightly. This tactical change is taking the piss. Come on. Thank you. Okay, let's do a in-match team talk. Try and... Whoa, someone's taking a knock. Let's go. What should we do? Push forward. We need to get a winner here. We've not conceded anything yet, but look, we've dropped down to 18th with that. And substitutes will be coming up soon. This is looking like a pretty shitty game, to be honest. Oh, crap. Don't let them score. Is that Gareth Ainsworth? Clough? Thomas? Oh, he's off the post. Oh, for God's sake. Oh, that's not... How many bloody goals are scored by rebounds in this game? Genuinely, there's a lot of goals being scored from rebounds. Like, the ball will hit the post and it always seems to drop to one of their players because the defence doesn't move. Let's see if that's the same case here. Clough's ball back, comes in here, goalkeeper dives for it. I've got two defenders there, yet none of them move. So that's not been fixed. That's good. Good, good, good. Right, well, in that case, well, I don't want to rewind. Let's change to overload then. There's nothing else I can really do in this situation other than do that because... Don't want to shoot on sight just yet. Don't want to get too desperate with it. Be more disciplined. No, I'm turning that off. Get a bit more freedom. I don't know why I had that on. That must have been from a previous game. I think, oh, it was from the Hull game. I tried to sort of set up and frustrate them. Hopefully we can get ourselves level in this game. I don't think we deserve to lose this. Wallace's ball in story! Where's the ball? Right, Alex Winter, and we've had another decent chance there, and we failed to take it. That's probably the issue here, and Winter with a terrible cross, which Burge will... guzzle up very, very easily. We need to make some substitutions. You know what I'm thinking? I was about to quote Bananas in Pyjamas then, but I decided against it. But I think I am B2. Wallace has been good. Oh, actually, Dissels can play on the left as well. That's good. I didn't notice that. Okay, that's good. We'll bring on Dissels to play in place of Bartsch because he's looking a bit knackered. Have we got a centre-back on the bench? No, we actually don't. That's a pain in the arse. We normally have loads of them. I've normally got centre-backs coming out my arse. This guy might not be a very good one here. This is looking like a scrappy game that we're not going to get anything from. What to do? Demand more? Yeah, come on. You're fucking Pompey. You don't not score goals. We've got just as much right to a point in this game as Coventry City do. I know you're exhausted, but there's nothing I can really do about it. 4 minutes. I don't think we're going to get anything in this game. This is going to be a shitty 1-0 defeat, I think, at home. And if you look at the... we've probably been the better... Oh, hello. That's a full-on highlight. Oh, no. He's going to shoot. He's going to score as well. Oh, wait. No. Ainsworth. Oh. That's going to be it, isn't it? God damn it. Oh, wait. Hang on. No. Nicky Shorey. Come on. Pick a good ball. Dissels. Or just lose it entirely. That's up to you. Hayden Mullins with the ball here. Gets it back out to Dunn. Fogden. Some quick play here. Get it out wide to Nicky Shorey. That wasn't the intentional pass, was it? Fogden now. Go on, Fogden. Good cross. No. Back to Shorey. Somebody do something. Fogden. Cross it for God's sake, Fogden. Get the ball in the box. Dissels. Marcus. Oh my God, he's missed it. If there was one person I thought I could count on, it would be the Marcus of Portsmouth to put that in the net. It's Wallace now. Surely we're not going to get another chance. I don't think we are we? No, we've lost. Bloody hell. I think we can call ourselves unlucky, I suppose, but for me, that wasn't that disappointing. I think we played okay and probably deserved to win that. I think you could make an argument that we did deserve to win that, probably, but at least deserved a draw. That was a little bit unlucky, I'd got to say. Looks like life in League One is going to be a little bit more difficult than our sort of stroll to success in League Two. Anyway, that's for sure. Thing is, right, it says here that Watmore has a fitness concern. There's a fitness concern about Watmore. Every time I say to him, I'm going to rest you, he goes, no, and gets really pissy at me. So what can I really do about it? Plus, I don't think he's that jaded anyway. Anyway, yeah, that's what it's done to the league. Let's just take a little look at League One now. So we are 16th place, 2 points off the relegation zone. We've actually only won one game. And I can't see us going down, but I also can't see us doing anything major. I think this is the sort of area we need to be aiming for this season, although I really do need to try and figure a way around these teams tactically. I think it might require a little bit more analysis before the games on my part, but that's down to me. And we will find out if that has been working in the next episode. Now, in the next episode, we've got quite a few games coming up. We've got the Johnson's Paint game against Southend, which I'll probably just put our week inside because I couldn't give a crap about it. And then because there's barely any prize money and the board don't care, so I'd rather just get out of it so we can concentrate on the league. Then we've got a whole run of league games: Rochdale away, Birmingham at home, Colchester, Scunthorpe and Crewe. Could be tough, but we'll just have to wait and see how that goes. Anyway, I'm sorry this episode has been so long, but if you're still with me, then brilliant, and feel free to drop a like on the video. If you've liked it, then feel free to drop a like on the video. If you liked it even more than that, feel free to hit that big old subscribe button, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Hopefully we won't be struggling quite as much by the time that comes around. I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.